My husband had a thing about this girl with a birthmark. Began when he was 16 and went on and on. Like a fever that wouldn't break. It's a story he used to tell against himself. His crush on Strawberry Allison was one of the things that charmed me about him.
Hey, Vic. See the new Form 6 chick? What do you reckon, Spunk?
Yeah, pretty good.
One, two, pigeon!
Sucked in. Oh, my God, what a shocker. Well, she's got a face like a half-sucked redskin.
Strawberry Allison wasn't the only damaged specimen to capture his imagination. His first love was a farm girl whose ring finger ended at the first joint, ripped off in a hay baler. That was over in a night. A teenage kiss. Not like Allison. I always assumed that the whole thing was just a mortifying memory. But later, I started thinking about that.
You know, I've been trying to get more poetry into the school paper.
Yeah, but I didn't really mean for everyone to see this.
Okay. Well, I just think it'd be a great experience for you as a writer, bearing your soul. Well, you think about it, okay?
What you doing, dickhead? Okay. Let's go.
Incandescent. They say that when you're there, you'll know. That when it's happening, you'll see. And it'll all be right. But it's not that way, is it? You say it's not what they think. You say to show them your face. To not be afraid of the burning girl. It's something else folded within itself. My burning girl.
Allison, I loved your poem. I thought it was really great.
So?
I think you're great.
Oh, where do you think you're going?
I was just gonna...
Why don't you just leave her the fuck alone?
Time heals all wounds, right? And a lot of times passed, all right. But then just last week, I caught him poring over something. This damn box. Crying. Oh, he didn't want to talk about it, he said. So we didn't.
Hi, guys.
Hey, guys.
Hi.
You all right?
Good. Just, you know, watching the fire.
I'm starting uni in a few weeks. We're driving to Perth tomorrow, me and Roberta.
Right.
I guess I'll see you later.
I still love your poem.
I still love you for loving it.
Sometimes I felt like a biographer, searching around for the one final telling detail at the center of my husband's life. Then I think of Strawberry Alison and the way my husband was drawn to her, to the pain he thought he saw. All very endearing until you think of it turned your way. That your husband's love might have been another act of kindness. As if you too might have been some kind of damaged goods.